Amateur FX coming at you at the European Open here. Just looking at our Facebook chart real quick. Still core short Facebook. It cannot get through this trend line, which has been satisfactory for the short side. What we're trying to do is buy low ones, sell high ones within this 180, 165 area, core short. Working out so far. See how we go. Tesla, our other big core short. Not as great, but still playing in this 300, 357 zone. We reinitiated shorts yesterday. We don't think Tesla's going to get above 360. So you want a core short average above 360 with a stop above 360. Anyway, just peanuts in that game. Let's get to currencies where the real meat is on the bone, dollar yen. Interesting day now. We have the death knock of this massive trend line that yielded 300 points. 108.08. 108.12 was the prior lows. This is going to be resistance first time. 90 was the high last night. Obviously, FOMC today. This is going to drive it. So, but we're going to keep an eye on this point. Could become pivot for further bullish action. But on the first print, we're going to sell. Yen crosses. A bit more mixed. We really like this 131.60 level as a momentum trade. Otherwise, we don't really have a view here in Euro Yen, nor do we have a view in Sterling Yen. Very choppy. Trend is down, but you're not selling it. You're not reselling in the bottom third of the overall range. Let's take a look at cable. We're patiently waiting for this trend line to come into play, if it comes into play. Otherwise, on the top side, the big moment is going to be 141.60. So, playing around at 139.83 seems like a bit of a waste of time. Be careful. The one thing I do want to say is the Brexit negotiations, the tone has changed. It looks like for the first time Europe is going fine. Let's just do Brexit. And Europe realizes now that they've taken their ego out of the equation. So it's almost like they were dating or they were married. Britain said, I want a divorce. Europe said, oh, that hurts. No one likes to be dumped. But then after about a year or so, Europe said, wow, life not being married to you is going to be way better. And so let's just get on this. Let's just get this done. They're going to get more financial revenue. They're going to get, they're going to have to pay less into the farm subsidy. They're going to get more employment. They're going to get more regulatory jobs. And the risk that other European countries are going to do a UK is very limited now. Because everyone now sees that the burden of this divorce is going to land on Britain's lap, not on Europe's lap at all. So I'm sensing this sea change here, which leads me to believe that some of these hard Brexit trades, you know, this War of the Roses type divorce trades, are going to unwind. And Euro Sterling is one of those trades. And it seems counterintuitive that okay, UK is going to take the brunt of this, but they've already taken the brunt. The currency has already taken the brunt of this. So, you know, they're basically pricing the UK into zero. And it's not going to be zero. It's going to be harder for them, but it's not going to be zero. And so this sort of friendly Brexit, let's just get this done before the end of the year, type of talk should lead to further euro sterling selling. The big point, obviously, is 86.90. At 88.15, I suggest selling against the 200 hour, which worked out pretty well yesterday. You had to sit through some pain up here, but any moves up towards 86.50, so 30, 40, 50, you want to have a light short in euro sterling. Okay, sermon over on Brexit. Dollar CAD coming up to some interesting points. This range high is going to coincide with the 200 day, 127.17, 126.89. First time up is a fade today, but if it goes through on a hawkish FOMC, don't fade it. Finally, dollar ZAR, waiting for this pivot at 11.80. Budget out today. The budget, you know, I don't know, there's some sort of metaphor about lipstick on a pig that we should be using, but financially, South Africa is doomed. It'll take a decade to move forward, and it'll take a decade of no corruption, a decade of no political problems, a decade of no droughts to get them back on their feet. So this budget here isn't going to change much and should be seen as negative by the skeptics out there like me. Anyway, I'll leave you guys with that. Have a good session. Save your bullets today. Don't want to dive into anything too harshly. FOMC will be much, much watched later on today. Good luck out there. Ciao.